So the command which was given to the soldiers to march onwards was issued by Lord Raglan, the overall commander of the British forces. And the actual command that Lord Raglan gave to the soldiers of the Light Brigade was to advance rapidly to the front, follow the enemy, and try to prevent the enemy from carrying away the guns. But there was a lapse in communication as the command was passed on from brigade to brigade, and like Chinese whispers, it lost its content. And most of the phrases were dropped. And finally, when the Light Brigade got the command, it only got two phrases: advance rapidly. So they realized the moment they got the command, they realized that it was an absurd order because the valley was surrounded by Russian artillery and forces on all three sides. And the worst part was that the command marched nonetheless, and they were surrounded by Russians, and it was a bloodbath because they literally had a hand-to-hand combat, and they fought with their sabers, their swords, and not their guns. And the superior officers who were witnessing whatever was happening on the battlefield from a distance realized the disaster which had taken place, and with the intention of preventing further damage or further disaster, they stopped the heavy brigade from following the light brigade, and thus the light brigade was completely sacrificed. So that's the context of the poem. So we are going to be looking at the theme, the structure, and the literary devices Tennyson uses to heighten the experience of the poem and heighten the underlying pathos and irony in the poem. And we'll look at these elements as we do a reading of the poem. Before we start with the actual poem, let me tell you that this is a lyric, and a lyric is normally a short emotional piece. It's not a very long creation like an epic or a ballad. It's a short emotional piece, and a lyric is primarily it's a subjective expression of the writer's personal experiences or feelings. And the stanzas of a lyric have a recognizable pattern. Now, this is how the poem begins. So here we have the first stanza. It says, "Half a league, half a league, half a league onward, all in the valley of death, rode the 600. Forward, the light brigade, charge for the guns," he said. "Into the valley of death, rode the 600." So that's the first stanza for you. Now, you might be wondering why I have color-coded the words. Each color represents a certain kind of element which I want you to focus on. Now, if you look at the words in red, first of all, I will ask you which phrases are repeated thrice. Just look at the stanza and think which phrases are repeated thrice. So you will realize that it's the words in red, half a league, half a league, half a league onward. Now, what does this indicate? It indicates a very slow and steady march of the soldiers. They could not move more than half a mile at a time. So they were marching very slowly, and the repetition enhances the inability of the soldiers to march forward at a pace, at a considerable pace, and indicates their sluggish pace. It also kind of symbolically conveys their march towards death.